Hi guys, good evening. Welcome back once again to the EdWord. I'm your host, Eddie, and in tonight's video, I will be doing my episode review for the latest episode of AMC's Fear the Walking Dead, which I just got done finishing a few minutes ago on AMC. Yikes! And awesome. Before I begin, of course, and I keep talking on and for too long, and I keep going into unnecessary detail, I forget to breathe. Please be warned that this is a spoiler-filled review. Again, if you're not caught up on Fear the Walking Dead by this episode or the past couple episodes, do not keep watching or listening, as I will be going into spoilers. So, you have been warned. That being said, again, spoilers from here on out, and there were quite a few of them tonight. So, here we go. Great episode. I am really, really digging this style of storytelling they're doing with cutting back from past to present. And, it's interesting. Like, in the past, we see Mel alive and well. And then within the opening scene of this episode, Alicia finally ends the bastard. You know, and the weirdest part, too, is that he looks like a gross, burnt zombie as he crawls out of the ambulance. Because when she first blew it up, I thought, oh, they killed Mel. Although he's a big antagonist, so if they're going to kill him, he's going to have a clearly on-screen death. And obviously, they did. She smashed his head in. So when he crawled out of the ambulance, I'm like, oh, he survived that initial blast. But, oh, he looks like shit. Oh, you know, he already kind of looks like a walker. But when he looked up at her and he was, like, raspily breathing, you're like, oh, okay, he's barely clinging on to dear life. But obviously, she's going to kill him. And she did. Good rinse to that asshole. Now, the one thing I was trying to figure out, if him and Charlie getting stranded from the rest of the vultures was part of a bigger trap to then release all the walkers on the stadium, but breaking your own ribs and going through a pretty painful experience like the way Mel did seems awfully extreme to carry out such an elaborate plan. So it seems like he genuinely did not want himself or Charlie to be there because he knew what his brother was going to do, and he was even trying to convince Madison of it as well. Perhaps him trying to convince her and everybody else to leave, or at least Naomi, was him actually being a decent person for once and trying to save lives before this disaster is unleashed upon him. But of course, in the world of The Walking Dead, or Fear the Walking Dead, in the Walking Dead world, it's always too late. You try to do the right thing or the nice thing for someone, and usually, not always, but sometimes, a good chunk of time, it ends up biting you in the ass just like that. And that is a good lesson to take away from tonight's episode. I can't say it. It's too mean. I was going to say, don't help people. I'm kidding, of course. I am totally, totally kidding. Of course you should help people. No, but in the world of The Walking Dead, it's like that old saying goes, no good deed goes unpunished, and I think tonight's episode was very, very evident proof of that. I might have missed it because my air conditioner is so damn loud, and I had my volume cranked up like crazy, but I think the markers were meant to signify how many walkers were in that particular area or trapped in a particular building, and the vultures were rounding them all up into trailers and trucks to be unleashed on an unsuspecting community, which is what they did. So I'm assuming that's what the numbers meant, or the markers meant, I think, right? Did I get that right? Sound off in the comments down below to confirm if I got that detail right or not. And speaking of detail, you know, one of the things I enjoy about this past and present back and forth storytelling is that it really keeps you on your toes, and it really makes you pay attention to detail. Like, you can't just sit back in a comfy chair and watch a show. I mean, of course you can. But if you really want to know what's going on and actually follow what is happening in chronological order, you've really got to pay attention to what the hell is going on in this episode. You know, I thought it was so great of Morgan. Instead of taking up arms and shooting against the vultures, his first priority was trying to save John's life. And then, even though Charlie killed Nick, and Luciana. You could tell that Luciana was tempted to pull that trigger. But fortunately, she was able to put her pumped shotgun to good use and blow away that nasty vulture guy from earlier. That was a pretty cool death. But you can tell Luciano is really struggling, wrestling with, do I really want to shoot a little girl even though she killed the love of my life? Nah, but I will shoot this guy, and blew him away. But, you know, I thought it was interesting how Morgan knows that this girl was on the wrong side of things, but he was still trying to save her because in his eyes, she's just a little kid who's caught, who's like with the wrong people, and she needs to get out of there. And I think that's what the title of this episode means, the wrong side of where you are. You've got these characters who are kind of stuck between these two groups, Madison's people and the Vultures. So you've got characters like Al, the tank driver, or the SWAT van driver, Naomi and Morgan and John, and apparently Charlie, all these characters who kind of have torn allegiances to both groups, or at least one of the groups. And while this bloody gun battle is going on, you know, they're trying to save a man's life, and they do convince Al to drive them back to the stadium where hopefully medical supplies are. And of course, just like that, you know, nobody said it was going to be easy. And I thought to myself, as she plows through the doors, I'm like, they're either going to find themselves surrounded by remaining survivors all pointing their guns at him, or there's going to be a herd in there. And sure enough, there was a massive herd in there still trapped within the stadium. But good thing they're in an armored vehicle, because that's going to come in handy, especially when Al pulls out those big machine guns that she's got on the side. And I liked how that's what she silently and sort of subtly threatened to use on Alicia if she didn't back off from Naomi and John, which I thought was pretty cool. You know, and I also like how this episode, how Madison is becoming a lot like Rick in a sense where she is trying to do the right thing while keeping her people, but above all, her children alive. And I think it's a real wake-up call for her when she dismissively sends Mel out because she's like, he doesn't want to be here, let him go, let him get out there. But then her kids come up with a pretty good point that she brought back Strand, she brought back them, they should be able to bring him back. Not bring him back physically, but bring him back also as a person. Like, it's kind of like what Mel said, people like you are extinct. Or he said something about the good people being gone or being extinct, to which Madison replied with a gun in his face, no one's gone until they're gone. And I think that's the idea that made Alicia and Nick drive out there to save him. And again, I doubt this is part of a big elaborate trap, because he seemed to steer off the road and he drove off because of his injury. And he was pretty out of it during the Walker unleashing on the stadium. So I don't know what we're going to see Mel do in the next episode, which is going to be the mid-season finale, by the way, for those of you who may have missed that detail. Next Sunday will be the mid-season finale, meaning the show will go briefly on hiatus, and then we'll presumably start back up later this summer or early in the fall. Hopefully in the summer, right? So we have had our first 8 episodes, and then we'll get another 8 episodes through later this year. We'll probably get a panel or a trailer for the second half of the season at Comic-Con, which is going to be happening at the end of next month in San Diego. So mark it on your calendars. New episode of Fear the Walking Dead airs next Sunday, and it is the mid-season finale, meaning we are concluding the first 8 episodes of this tremendously awesome season. God, this season is so good. This season is almost as good, if not better, than season 1, which I seriously think is one of the best seasons of this series, was the first one. But damn, this fourth one is coming to a close second. I really thoroughly am enjoying this. I did not like how John's fate was kind of briefly touched upon, although I kind of get it because he's kind of had the spotlight for the past couple episodes, and now we need to focus on other characters. But at least he is still breathing, and he had better stay alive too by the end of the next episode. Although it does warm my heart and pleases me when I saw the fans' reactions last week after the end of last week's episode when he got shot. Everybody came out supporting and just doing a total outcry of support for John, and fans have really taken to this character, as have I, so I'm pleased to see that people really care. So what did you guys think of tonight's episode? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Were you expecting more, expecting less, etc., etc.? Please leave your thoughts, opinions, and your feedback down below in the comments section. I'd love to hear from everybody. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing to this channel for more episode reviews like this one. Don't forget, the mid-season finale of Seasons 4 of Fear the Walking Dead airs next Sunday on AMC. Don't miss it. All right, guys, have a great rest of the week. Thanks for watching. And of course, until next time, may the Force be with you.